Sure, thank you very much, Subhani. Now we move on to the next topic, raising this robotic EMD and next surgery by Dr.Venkata Karthikeyan. Short story about Venkata Karthikeyan. He finishes the MS grades, EMD and fellowship in USA. It's very interesting, he is the first doctor to perform in India's first pediatric robotic neck surgery. This is the first person. He received the Kamini Charity Trust prize for the best postgraduate student at the Autoimmune University at AIIMS in 2001. And the first EMD surgeon from India under the International Fellowship Program to receive the Advanced Fellowship in Neurology and Skull Base of India. So with this, I welcome Dr.Venkata Karthikeyan. Please come forward.
Or the chemo radiation again dealing with side effects of chemoradiation, which includes speech and swallowing problems, and radiation side effects. So the transfer robotic surgery, the advantages are it has 10 times magnification of a normal human eye, and it has a 3D visualization. If you see here, the surgeon sitting here, and the robot here, and this is the end view we get through the console, the 3D images, and surgeons just like in open surgery, we make the hand movements, which will be transmitted to the endoscopic arm or the robotic arms, and you can see the bedside assistant helping, and the nurse on the other side. So so there are several advantages. One is the improved dexterity, the 7 degrees of freedom, and ability to scale the motions, and the surgeon can sit comfortably and do the surgery. So we have done more than 45 cases of both transfer body surgery and neck surgery, including thyroidectomy. Preoperative imaging is very, very important to assess the tumor, especially we need to look at the position of the carotid artery. When you do a transfer robotic surgery, we need to know the carotid artery is not retropharyngeal, which is a contraindication, because we don't want to damage or injure the carotid artery. So we do a selective therapeutic medical sessions for transfer robotic surgery. We remove the lymph nodes, at the same time we ligate the vessel, we ligate the lymph artery. We ligate the facial artery, we ligate the superior laryngeal artery, depending on the location of the tumor. So for transfer robotic surgery, this is a setup. The surgeon sitting at the console here, the assistant at the head end of the patient here, and the patient's side part is here, and the tissue is at the front end, and then us on the opposite side. In the patient's side card, you have the old system, SA system, or the new system, the XA system. This is again the surgeon sitting in the console here. We use a special retractor called FK retractor, which opens the mouth widely. And you have the bedside assistant taking care of the arms, the endoscopic arms, and also suctioning and leggage of the vessels and clipping of the vessels. And you have, just like the human surgeon, you have the central arm, which is the eye of the surgeon to the endoscope. And we thirdly use one forceps and one scissors. So one is you can use the very length bipolar forceps, other one is the monopolar spatula or a scissor. Yeah, this is what we do for early total cancer. So this early lesion in the right tonsil, if you see here, just by doing a radical prostatectomy, which is different from a conventional prostatectomy, where we remove the superior constrictor also, has an advantage of the T1 tonsil, remove the tonsil of cancer with wide margin, you don't need to subject them for radiation, 6 weeks of radiation, or chemotherapy for that matter. So the aortic tube you can see here, this is the monopolar spatula, and this is the metal bipolar forceps. You can see the clear plane, and the advantage is this is what you see here is the 2D image, but what the surgeon sees in the console is a 3D image. And the depth perception is also good. We can differentiate the normal tissue from the cancer tissue. So we can remove the tumor precisely, even from different angles and different corners. That's the advantage of robotic surgery as compared to other endoscopic surgery, because the freedom of movement when you get to the robotic arms. So we used to use the tissue flow for just for hemostasis. Now we don't do that. The pathological assessment is very important. We need to assess the margins. Suppose early lesion, we need to make sure that margins are negative, because that's going to decide our treatment whether the patient needs radiation or not. So you need to discuss with your pathologist about the margins after the surgery. Post-operative care, you can remove the residue between a week to 10 days, and antibiotic for a week and mouthwash. Hemorrhage is one of the complications we need to take into consideration. So we like it that this is the third time of intersection for natural robotic surgery. Still, we need to make sure that the natural hemostasis is available.
Okay. बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं होता ऐसा लगता
है. Anyway, he is able to swallow normally, speaking normally, and he operated on the supervisor. So the other indication is shown in the robotic neck surgery. There's no scar on the neck. That's the advantage, because neck surgeries can be associated with ugly scars, especially in young male, young female, and young female, socially active people who doesn't want a scar. This is a very good option where we hide the scar behind the ear and behind the wings. So this is the retroactive approach endoscopic surgery where we hide the scar behind the hallux. You can see the hallux turn and behind the ear. And that OR set up again. And so another advantage is for robotic neck surgery, robotic type of surgery, especially for heavy carried knee, you can So when you get a solid carried nodule, arising from one lobe, where you want to avoid neck scar.
Thank you.